Hi gang, Steve Hart here. Today I want to talk to you about what I would call reactionary programming. And what I mean by that is we will often react to things that are happening to us. And when we feel as though we're being victims of the situation or something's being coming at us, we want to react. And it's a normal part of our ego to protect ourselves. It's about preservation. It's about safety. That's why we have this ego. When we came into this world, we were given an ego to help us survive in this world until we come to a place of awakening to our true spiritual being as to who we are, living in physical bodies. And it's not until we come into that awareness that we begin to see how the ego has been there to protect us, to so we can survive through this world. Now, so the reactionary programming comes with that, and the worldly system reinforces that. So what I want to talk about today is how to free yourself. As I've throughout the years, I've gone through a slow awakening and learning how to be in the present moment. And in the present moment, instead of reacting, you give a response, a chosen response. And so I've had to learn to make choices. When something would happen or something was presented to me, I found myself having a tendency to react. And after I reacted, I'm going, gee, I don't wonder if that was the best response. is that really what I really wanted? And especially in relationships, when you're in a relationship and someone says something to you and you blurt back, the first thing that comes to your mind, you go, well, maybe I shouldn't have said it that way. So over the years, I began to actually hear my reaction in my head, and then I would say, no, that's not what I wanted to say. That's not what I want to do. And I began to choose a response to that. And life is much better, much happier for me as I've done so. So what it comes down to is being aware of who you are and to realize that you're not a victim of this world and that you can actually step into your power and that you have the ability to make a choice. Now, the way in which I've done that is by connecting to my higher self. You know, I identify with the fact that I have an ego and I have this mind, which is a sort of a playground of thoughts that is tied into this system. And so I learned to make a choice to listen and connect to my higher self. And I refer to my higher self because that is the true being of who I am. And it is speaking to me and revealing to me the truth of what is. As I live in this world, I get to make better choices by listening to my higher self. And by doing so, it has saved me a lot of heartache, a lot of frustration, a lot of anger and hatred and all the ugly stuff that comes along with the ego trying to protect itself. So, you know, every day we're confronted with something. I know right now, just recently, we've been confronted with the net neutrality issue. And the media wants us to react and to draw a conclusion without even looking at the truth of the possibilities of what this really means. It was very confusing to me. So I've had to stop and not react and to go in and figure out what's the truth in this. As I do with a lot of things, everything. It has saved me, like I said, a lot of heartache and confusion and frustration by me just not reacting and stepping back and looking at the big picture and bringing in all of the possibilities of what piece of truth is involved in that, so I can come to a conclusion that is peaceful for me, that is one that is in harmony with the universe. And I can't do that if I'm reacting. And The only way I can do that is by giving the response that I want to give to that is in alignment with my truth. Now, my truth changes every day as I'm evolving in my awareness, and as I expand my awareness of the truth, I find more and more, and I let go of that which I thought was true, and it expands out. And this is all part of freeing myself from this matrix system, which the world is perpetrates upon us, which our ego is attached to. It feeds off of that. The world feeds fear to me, and it wants me to react. Instead, I let go of my fear, and as I connect to my higher self, I am pulled up into the love, and fear does not control me. And there have been several incidences just in the last few years where something happened, and if I hadn't been at this level of awareness, I would have reacted and probably got myself in trouble. Everything from saying something to someone to an auto accident or someone committing some kind of a threat to me. I've learned to not react to it, and it has saved me many, many times over. And I'm sharing that with you today because I'm having a great deal of peace and joy in this, and I hope that you can too. So maybe you can take the words I'm sharing with you and apply it to your life. Thank you. God bless.